Look what's in the paper.
What?
Wow, everybody. Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Look what's in the paper.
Mickey Mouse?
No. Somebody very important is going to come down on Sesame Street.
The mayor?
No, somebody more important.
The governor?
No. Somebody of national, a national figure.
Uh-huh. National.
Yes.
The American Eagle.
That's close.
Good.
The President of the United States.
What?
No. Well, you're kidding.
No. It says from his hotel, the President will drive to the airport up Lexington Avenue and across 125th Street with a detour down Sesame Street.
Wow.
Wow, the President is going to come to Sesame Street.
Yes.
Gee. Ooh. Hey, what'll we wear? Maybe we should dress up.
Look, that's not the problem. Look at this street. It's a mess.
Oh, boy.
You're right. The only time maybe the President will come down to Sesame Street. And look what it looks like.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
We still got time. If we all work together, we can make it look good.
Yeah.
All right.
Want them to see like this.
Okay. I'll tell you what. I'll clean up in front of my store.
Okay. I'll wash the windows
right now.
I'll wash the windows.
And I'll pick up the trash. Well, I'm gonna go sweep down in front of 123. Mm-hmm. So, what are you gonna do?
I think I'll write him a poem.
Write him a poem.
Yeah. Gee, just think. The President of the United States is going to visit Sesame Street. Wow.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're proud to present those two international favorites, Herman Happy and Stanley Sad.
I'm very, very happy.
I'm very, very sad.
I always laugh and giggle.
Nothing makes me glad.
I grin and chuckle all the day, don't even have to try.
I always frown and mope around, sometimes I even cry.
It's fun to be so happy.
It's rotten to be sad.
I'm peppy and I'm snappy.
Boy, do I feel bad.
My feelings are as different as polka dots and glass.
Cause he's so gosh darn happy.
And he is always sad.
Poor happy fella. One of the saddest things I've ever seen. Terrible. Can't believe anybody could be so happy. Oh, my.
Ernie, what are you doing here? I thought you weren't coming back for a week from camp. You wrote to me, remember?
Well, Bert, I changed my mind.
Well, but you were having so much fun, you know, fishing and swimming, you said?
Mm-hmm. I was, Bert.
Well, so what are you doing back?
Well, Bert, I got to thinking about my rubber ducky, Bert.
Your rubber ducky?
Mm-hmm. I found that I missed my rubber ducky, Bert. And then I got to thinking about my bed.
Your bed?
And I found that I missed my bed, too, Bert.
Oh, Ernie.
And then I was thinking about Maria and Gordon and Mr. Hooper and you, Bert.
Me?
Yeah, I missed my old buddy, Bert.
But Ernie, I thought you found a new old buddy in camp.
Well, it's not the same as having an old buddy, Bert, you know?
Oh.
And I guess I was sort of homesick and...
Gee.
I was,
I was sad,
Bert, actually.
You
I was very sad, yes.
Oh, Ernie, I was thinking you'd forgotten all about me and...
Oh, forget about you, Bert? Oh, yeah. Never, Bert. Listen, Bert, did you miss me?
Oh, I sure did. I sure did. Welcome home, Ernie.
Oh, Bert, oh, that makes me so happy now. Wonderful. Hey, let me show you what I got you from Camp Winnie Wonga.
From Camp Winnie Wonga. Yep. Oh, yeah, show me,
I got
me,
all
show
kinds
me.
Of great stuff here.
Oh, let me see.
Well, just a second. I got...
Oh, yeah.
Just a minute here.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Now, looky. Oop,
wow, out. Look at that.
Okay, you see that stuff?
Yeah.
Look here. That's a bird's nest.
A real bird's
That's
nest?
That's a real bird's nest.
I mean, from twigs and everything?
It's made out of genuine mud and twigs.
Wow, a Rooney.
Okay, now looky here.
Oh, boy.
Here's a bottle. This is a bottle of Camp Winnie Wonga water.
Winnie Wonga water?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Those are little plastic fish that are floating inside there. They're souvenirs of Camp Winnie Wonga.
They sell plastic fish?
Mm-hmm. Well, they're cheap, Bert, you know. And down here, Bert, look at this. I got a rock.
Oh, wow.
I found that on the shore of Camp Winnie-Wonga.
Isn't that terrific?
Isn't that neat?
Hey, you know what I got over here? I got four new paper clips.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I got three Acmes and one Standard. Aren't they terrific?
Hey, Bert,
I just tied them onto the rest of them here.
I got you a paper clip from Camp Winnie-Wonga.
You got me a Winnie-Wonga paper clip?
That's genuine. That's a genuine Winnie-Wonga camp paperclip.
Oh, that's terrific. Oh, thank you so much, Ernie.
Bert, you know, I'm so happy to be home.
Me too. Okay, what do you got? Look here. Look at that.
Look at this rock, Bert.
Plastic fish, huh?
This one reminds me of you, Bert.
I'd like to talk to you about the word up. U-P. Up. All right. Up is the way this arrow is pointing. Right up into the air. Now let me see. What else can I tell you about up? Well, if you wanted to go away up high, there are several ways you could do it. For instance, you could, can't seem to think of anything. There must be some way to go up. Well, if you wanted to go way high up in the sky, you could. I just don't know what you'd do if you wanted to go way high up in the sky. There must be some way to go way high up in the sky. I hear people talking about it all the time. It's beginning to rain. Rain does not go up. Rain comes down. Maybe I'd better talk about down. Yes, that's what I'll do. Now, most things that go up come down. I hope you've learned something from my little talk. Who put those things in the middle of the sidewalk? Don't they know that's dangerous?
Well, we have the high notes and we have the low notes. These are the high notes and these are the low notes. You go up to the high notes, like... And you go down to the low notes. Do it faster, from the low notes to the high notes, and from the high notes to the low notes. Just like this.
Mind closing our open? Thanks.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Olivia. Hey, let me see what I got. A brand new doormat that says,
nice.
Welcome.
Oh, hey, look, I got a lot of dirt here. You got a dustpan?
Oh, you don't need one. You could just sweep it right under here.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you swept all around in front of my door.
Oh, it's nothing. Everybody wants the street to look good, you know.
Yeah, well, we don't want the president to think we live in a dump.
Oh, no, it's my street, and I want it to look good.
Yeah, and it's my street, too, huh?
Yeah.
Gee, You know, this is my most favorite street in the whole wide world.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Why, I know everybody here and everything on it. Yeah.
Hello, lamppost, hello, tree. Hello, people smiling at me. I'm at home and it's a treat. Walking down my street.
Hello, bus stop, hello, store. Hello, steps in front of my door. Feeling good 'cause life is sweet. Walking down my street. I know every crack that's in the sidewalk. I know where the street begins and ends.
I know all the windows on the houses. Like the people in them, they're my friends. Hello, playground, hello, swing.
Hello, summer, winter, and spring.
Happy face and happy feet. Walking down my street. Hello, car.
Hello, friends, wherever you are. I just hope someday we'll meet.
Walking down my street.
Right. Now, come on, let's clean up our street.
You got it.
Okay. Perfect.
Cat. Black cat.
White cat.
Orange marmalade cat.
Mouse cat.
Bird cat.
Chasing balls of string cat.
Cat.
Meow.
You know what that is?
Sure, that's a traffic light. It tells the cars when to stop and go.
And it tells people when it's okay to cross the street. The light on the top is red. That means stop. When the light is red, everybody has to stop. The light on the top means stop.
The light on the top means stop. That's the red light. How about the light on the bottom?
Light on the bottom means go. That's the green light.
Green means go. The light on the bottom means go.
We're pretty lucky we have traffic lights. You know what would happen if we didn't have traffic lights?
What?
This.
Traffic lights.
C. Canary. C.
We
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Hello, hello, this is Green Frog calling CTW Central. Do you read me? Hello, hello, 10-4. Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the cottage. This is the cottage of the poor little shoemaker and his wife. Now, as you recall, the poor little shoemaker used up all his leather to make his last pair of shoes, and now he has no more leather and no more shoes.
Hey, will you keep it down? I'm trying to sleep up here.
I'm sorry about that.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
It's very touchy. In any case, I think somebody is coming in here now. Let's see whom it is. Pardon me, this is the cottage of the poor little shoemaker. Can I ask whom you are?
Gee, guys, look, it's Kermit the Frog from Sesame Street News.
In person.
Gee, we watch you every night.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're elves, and
yeah.
I'm Squeaky.
I'm Sneaky.
And I'm Leaky.
I'm sorry to hear that, but I've heard of you elves. You come to people's houses in the middle of the night and help them out. Is that right?
Yeah. Oh, you got it, Frog. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. When they wake up in the morning, mm-hmm. there's presents from us. Hey, we ought to bring them on in here.
Yeah.
Okay, well, viewers, you heard it right from the elves' mouths. These elves are going to work all night, and when the poor little shoemaker wakes up in the morning, he's going to have a whole bunch of new shoes to sell. Let's watch. Here comes the first shoe now. Pardon me, Squeaky?
No, I'm Sneaky.
Sneaky, I forgot. What is this thing here?
It's Stew. What's it look like, a trampoline?
Stew? No, wait a second. You're supposed to bring a shoe. Now, Stew rhymes with shoe, but you're supposed to bring a shoe.
Sorry about that.
Listen, what is this? This is a canoe.
Yeah.
Now, canoe also rhymes with shoe, but you're supposed to bring a shoe, not a canoe. Listen, Squeaky.
No, I'm Leaky. This is my canoe.
This is a leaky canoe?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Wait. Now that's a kangaroo. Now, kangaroo also rhymes with shoe. But you guys are supposed to bring shoes, not stews and canoes and kangaroos.
Who is this guy?
Come on now.
What is going on down here? Can't a man and his wife get some sleep? What is this?
Oh, look, poor little old shoemaker husband, dear. It's the elves.
Yeah. There seems to be some sort of a problem. They were supposed to bring you shoes, but instead they brought you
Look, Stew, and a canoe.
Yeah.
And a darling kangaroo.
Yeah, but you don't understand. You see the...
Hey, Squeaky. Hey, all this stuff looks like terrific. This is wonderful.
Hey, wait a second. Do you know these guys?
Hmm? Oh, sure. Last time they brought us some glue and a honeydew and a tube of shampoo. Yeah, and a case of the flu.
Yeah, but you still don't have any leather and you don't have any shoes. What about your shoe business?
Well, I'll tell you the truth, Frog. I was never good at the shoe business. I think maybe I'll be a lawyer. Hey, that's it. I'll be a lawyer. Okay, line up for Stew, guys. Here we go.
Oh, all right, I'll get the bowl.
Well, this is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the cottage of the poor little shoemaker or the poor little lawyer. And, returning you to your regularly scheduled program.
Get out of my house, Frog.
Yes, there's no business like shoe business, folks.
Oh, all right. Okay.
Banana.
watermelon. Peach. Grape. Cantaloupe. Papaya. Grapefruit. Pineapple. Strawberry. Blueberry. And a cherry. Fruit salad.
La palabra abierto, ábrete sésamo. Abierto.
Oh, hello there, everybody. This is your little furry pal Grover, and I have with me a carrot. Juicy, delicious, and crunchy. And I am going to eat this carrot right now. Oh! Look who it is coming! The amazing Mumford! Hey! Maybe he will do a trick for us. He does wonderful magic tricks, you know. Mumphy!
Hmm?
Mumphy, it is your old pal Grover!
Yes, Grover.
Oh, it is so good to see you. Mumphy, maybe you could do something for us.
Well, I don't have much time, Grover. Oh,
this will not take long. I thought maybe you could do something for me and the boys and girls. Something like, you know, maybe, oh... Hey, this carrot! Make this carrot disappear, would you please?
Hmm? Oh, well, my. What a juicy, crunchy, delicious-looking carrot.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, indeed. I would be happy to make this carrot disappear.
Did you hear that, boys and girls? Oh, that is wonderful. And, Mumphy,
mm-hmm.
could you kind of make it do it with a big puff of smoke? Kind of make it... impressive?
Hmm? Oh, all right. Stand back.
Yes, oh, this is going to be so much fun. Okay.
A la peanut butter sandwiches.
Oh, look at all the smoke you did, Mumphy. That is wonderful. Did I not tell you?
There you are, all gone.
Oh, you have made the carrot disappear.
Mm-hmm.
Where is it? It is gone.
Mm-hmm.
He is so good. Okay, now make it appear again. Here we go. Bring it back. Bring it back.
I can't bring it back, Grover. I ate it.
You ate it?
Mm-hmm.
But, Mumphy, that was not magic.
No, but it sure was delicious. And you didn't say anything about magic.
J. J for jacket. J for jump? J for jerk? Jiggle? Juggle? Is this a joke? Jenny and Jeff.
Hey, come on, let's go.
Jenny and Jeff, you get away from that jacket. Jacket. J for jacket.
Oh, Oscar.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the president is going to come by Sesame Street today, and we're cleaning up the street. Don't you want to help?
Me? Help?
Mm-hmm.
Clean up?
Yes.
You must be mad. Huh. Besides, don't worry about me. I'm doing my part.
You are?
Sure. Like when the president comes by here. Why, we're going to raise the old glory up there on the flagpole. And we're going to give him a military salute with a gun.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, look at the flag here. Raise the flag. Here we go. There we are. Old glory.
Wow, Oscar, that's a very nice flag, but it only has 13 stars on it.
So what if it's a little old? Besides, this is a Grouch's favorite flag.
Now, why is that? Because the 13 stars stand for the 13 original states?
Wrong. Because 13 is a good unlucky number. Yeah. Now, we're going to get ready to give him an 11-gun salute.
The president is supposed to get a 21-gun salute.
Not from me.
Why not?
Because he only got 53% of the vote. So, and besides, he's lucky to get 11. Why, even the Grand High Grouch only gets 18. Okay, well, hey, you guys ready down there? The Royal Grouch Fusiliers are going to blow off a cannon. Okay, get ready, you guys. You ready?
Yeah.
Fire! That's one. Okay. Go. Two. Three. Four. Five.
Oscar, that's enough. Thank you. I got the idea.
We what? Got six more to go here.
Let's go.
Go.
21 guns. 21
That's seven. There's eight.
Oscar, that's enough. I've really had it. I really don't want to hear anymore.
Look, this is a rehearsal, so we got to get these right. Come on, you guys. Next one. Yeah, there's nine. Ten. Oh, hey, okay, only one more to go. This time with feeling. Wait a minute, I'll come down, you guys. Let's make this a really big one. Get ready.
Uh-oh.
11!
You all right?
Man, what a great ride. Wow, hey. Well, how'd you like this salute?
Oh, it was awful.
Yeah, it sure could have been better. I guess we're just going to have to rehearse it some more. All right, you guys, get the cannon ready.
No.
Let's rehearse some more.
No.
Take it from the top.
Oh, no.
Let her rip.
Oh, no.
One.
Hey, Butter, you deserve a pat on the head.
Oh, Red, you're always loafing around.
Oh. Hey, you guys, stop hamming it up.
Hey, come on, let us not fight.
Hey, everybody. You know, I think I hear somebody coming towards our refrigerator. I hope they're hungry.
Me too.
Oh, yeah.
I'm really hungry. Let's see what I can find that'll be good to eat. I wonder which one I should have. Everything looks so good. I guess I'll have to think about it.
She has to think about it. What she should have is a nice slice of bread. She couldn't go wrong with me.
Well, what makes you think you're so important?
Well, it's not important.
She wants some meat.
Exactly.
Yeah, no. She loves salad. She'll choose me.
Butter.
No. Shh.
I know. I'll have a piece of bread and butter. Uh-huh. Oh, on the other hand, I could make me a nice salad with this lettuce. Or maybe I could have a delicious piece of ham and cheese. Oh, I better think some more.
Oh, hear that? She's thinking about me.
I'm the best one to eat. She's going to want me.
No. She wants me. She wants salad.
Forget it, Leafy. She wants me.
No, stop, everybody. Wait a minute. Now, listen to me. Instead of each of us saying we're the best, why don't we work together?
Oh, you mean cooperate.
Yes.
Cooperate.
Oh. Right.
Yeah. Hey, why not?
Okay.
Here's what we do.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Good idea. Butter. This sure is a tough choice. Maybe if I took one more look, it would help me decide. Wow! A ham and cheese sandwich with lettuce and butter. Funny, I don't remember seeing that before. But it looks so good. I think I'll take it.
Yeah, we did it!
Yes, we cooperated.
Yeah, we all did it together.
Yeah. Butter.
I'm broken.
J. I was named after the letter J because everything my family does starts with a J.
There are folks who poke fun at the way my family's run. It's a joking, joyful, jumping jamboree. So if you'd like a job, just join our jolly mob, and we'll show you how much fun a J can be. My sister's into judo. My father likes to jog. My mother washes jelly jars. My uncle jumps a log. Big brother flies a jet plane. My nephew drives a Jeep. Junior is a jitterbug. And Grandma juggles sheep. My niece plays in a jazz band. My granddad Jimmy's doors. My cousin runs a jackal farm. My auntie judges boars. Great uncle raises John Quills. Great granddad plays with jacks. My wife became a journeyman. And me, well, I just stay out of their way. Jay.
Hi. Now, you know what we're going to talk about today? We're going to talk about up. Now, I'm going to show you what up is. U-P-up. Now, watch this. I'm going to jump up. Jump up. Wait a minute. Let's try that again. No, I know I can do it. You see, I'm going to jump up. Just up. Here goes. Oh, goodness. Wow. I go up, but I keep coming down. Maybe you can't go up without coming down. That must be it. Hey, what's happening, gang? How you doing?
Fine.
You know, I just found out that you can't go up without coming down.
I can't.
Oh, no. Nobody can go up without coming down.
I can't.
Really? Well, no, I can't believe that. Now, wait a minute. Let me see. I'm going to ask you to go up. Wow. Now, how do you suppose they did that?
I love your funny face, your sunny, funny face, for your cutie with more than beauty. You've got a lot of personality, and you fill the air with smiles for miles and miles and miles. Though you're no Mona Lisa, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face. Mm-hmm. Funny face. Mm-hmm. Funny face. You're not exotic, but so hypnotic. You're much too much. If you can cook the way you look, I'd swim the ocean wide just to have you by my side. Though you're no Queen of Sheba, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face.
When he comes by, give him a great big wave, all right?
Yeah, and I'm going to read my poem.
Okay. Look, there's a car. Wave.
Oh, I see it.
Hello there, Mr. President.
Oh, the paper. Just the bus.
Well, you know, I sure hope he shows up and doesn't disappoint us. I mean, after we cleaned up Sesame Street and everything.
Yeah, and I wrote my poem. Oh, somebody's coming now. Hello there, Mr. President.
Oh,
we're happy you to meet.
Oh, look, Mr. McIntyre.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
We thought you were the President of the United States.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Does he sell fruit, too?
No, he doesn't sell fruit, but he is coming through Sesame Street today.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
Wait a minute, look! They see the motorcycles? The motorcycles!
Oh,
and then the President's car by the motorcycles!
Oh, great.
Whoa.
I'm gonna get ready.
Hey, gang! That's the President of the United States!
Wow. Here goes. Hello there, Mr. President. And welcome to our...
Forget it. It's too late.
Too late?
He's already gone.
I didn't even see him. Where gone?
I didn't even see him either.
Well, I didn't think you'd go by that fast.
Gone? Gone? But doesn't anybody want to hear my poem?
What's happening, man?
I don't know.
What's that?
I don't know.
Looks like a fish hook.
It's not official. It's a J.
A what?
The letter J. Like to hear a story about the letter J, boys?
Yes.
Once upon a time, a guy named Joe noticed a June bug on his toe. Put it in a jar and started to go. But here come the judge and said, no, no, no. So Joe said why and started to jump and dance a jig on an old tree stump. Then jogged along to the city dump where he jammed the June bug in a tire pump. Then the judge caught up and started to wail and said to Joe, justice will prevail. Then the jury met and set the bail and Joe got an hour in the city jail.
So that's the letter J.
It still looks like a fish hook.
You know what else we learned?
Yeah, don't drive a judge by jamming a June bug.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Hey, you know what letter comes after I?
J!
Right. And whenever I think of the letter J, I think of all my friends whose names begin with the letter J, like J. Joe, wearing jeans. Got himself a pocket full of jelly beans. J. Joe jeans and his jelly beans. Hey, let's sing a song about J.
Hey, you know, I got a friend whose name begins with J, too.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah, let me tell you about her. J. Jane jumping down the lane, joking and a jiving, well, it's just like Jane. J. Jane jumping Jane. J. Joe jeans and his jelly beans. Hey, let's sing a song about J.
Hey, you know what, fellas?
What's that?
I got a J friend, too.
Oh,
yeah? Yeah.
Tell us about him.
J. Jim, he's tall and slim. He's got a jar of jam. Let's join with him.
J. Jim, let's join with Jim. J. Jane, well, let's jump with Jane. J. Joe jeans and his jelly beans. Hey, let's sing a song about J.
Hey, I have one too, my friend Jones.
Tell us about it.
Oh, okay, yeah. Here it goes.
Yes, sir.
J. Jones. Jaw went on the phone, hear a jingle, hear a jangle, well, it's just for Joan.
J. Joan, yeah, jingle, jangle, Joan. J. Jim, let's join with Jim. J. Jane, well, let's jump with Jane. J. Joe, jeans and a jelly beans. Hey, let's sing a song about
it's the letter J. J, 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 J. So, letter J goes J, 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 J. Hey, here he comes! J, 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 oin, oin. Ja, 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 oin, join, 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 join. There they go, join, join, join. Look at that big ump, ump. It's blocking the track. Ja, 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 ump. I know, jump, jump. Jump, jump! Jump, 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 now he's just junk.
The potato. Ever wonder where it comes from? It came from... Where did it come from? The cupboard! That's where potatoes come from, the cupboard. Don't you think?
No. Everybody knows they come from a supermarket.
Oh, really? Let's look.
Potatoes. Look, you were right. Potatoes must come from the grocery store then.
No.
Well, where do they come from then? I just don't know.
Hi, Uncle George.
Uncle George? What's he doing here?
I drive a truck.
Oh, can you tell me where these potatoes come from?
Uncle George, you better help her out.
Sure. Follow me.
Potatoes.
There you go. That's where I pick up the potatoes before I deliver them to the store.
Into the boat you go. I have room for 20 numbers. Number one, two, move along, lads. Three, four, five, six, seven, step lively. Eight, smartly now, move along, nine. Blow me down, numbers overboard. Hang on, lads. It's a good thing you know how to swim. Let's go, me hearties, ten. Into the boat, 11, 12, step lively, 13, 14, 15, move along, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, blow me down to 20, that's it, mates, 20 is all I've got room for. Let's weigh anchor and cast off.
Good evening. Once again, it is time for another episode of Monsterpiece Theater. And here is your host, Alistair Cookie.
Pip, pip, and good evening. Alistair Cookie here. Me delighted to welcome you to Monsterpiece Theater. Tonight, me happy to bring you episode number 793 of Upstairs, Downstairs. And now, upstairs, downstairs.
Well, well, well. Prithee, here am I, downstairs. I believe I shall go upstairs. Well, here am I, upstairs. I believe I shall go downstairs. Well, here am I, downstairs again. I believe I shall go upstairs. once more upstairs. I believe I shall go downstairs. Well, here I find myself downstairs again. Oh boy, I think I shall go upstairs. Is this not exciting and dramatic? Well, here am I, upstairs. I think that I shall go downstairs. Tomorrow for another exciting episode of Upstairs, Downstairs. Oh, you got to be kidding! This Alistair Cookie saying good night for Monsterpiece Theater. On!
Ladies and gentlemen, the fabulous four flying Flatirons. What are they up to today? Well, they're going up. Wait a minute. One of them is coming down. It's okay. They're going up again. Goes up. And here he comes down. But he's going up again. And down he comes.
10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 tiny turtles on the telephone, talking with the grocery men. We would like some lettuce. Will you send us pinheads, please? And 10 sweet potatoes and 10 rutabagas with the dimples on their knees. Send us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 artichokes.
10 eggplants, over easy. That's one of our little jokes. 10 leafy, leafy collard greens, and please make sure they're washed. Light up our eyes, brighten our lives with 10 banana squash. We'll need 10 cans of black-eyed peas. They give you good, strong muscles. 10 of those tasty sprouts, the ones that they call Brussels. We'd also like 10 mangoes. They're the favorite of our sister Gert. And one last thing, please do include 10 apples for dessert.
10.
I just finished printing a letter to the president.
The president?
Why?
Well, a little while ago, Olivia said, gee, wouldn't it be nice if the street looked as neat and clean as this?
Yes.
You know, because we cleaned it all up for the president to drive down Sesame Street.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, you said it wouldn't be nice if it always looked like this.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
It would be
well,
nice.
That's why I wrote this letter.
Yeah. What's it say?
Well, it says...
Okay.
Dear Mr. President, it goes on, will you please drive down Sesame Street every day so we'll have to keep it clean? Your feathered friend.
I imagine a president writing that Sesame Street
every day.
And twice on Saturday, right? come on, Big Bird.
I mean, really, was that such a bad idea?
Well, come to think of it. It's not such a bad idea.
Big Bird, I'm getting you an envelope.
Oh, good. I need a stamp.
I've got the stamp.
Oh, wow.
Now, is this all you
want to
write?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters C and J and by the number 10. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.